Hello friends, today we'll discuss the MCQs on TIG welding, MIG welding and plasma arc welding. I will explain every answer with the help of appropriate diagrams and videos. So let's begin with the first question. What is also referred as a GTAW? We know that GTAW is nothing but the gas tungsten arc welding, which is also called as a TIG welding. TIG welding means that is a tungsten inert gas welding in which electrode is used, which is non-consumable, and inert gas used as a argon, or we can use the helium to keep the contamination away from the metal surface. And that's why in this case, our answer is TIG welding. It means that GTAW is nothing but the TIG welding. Next question. What is the name of welding process if arc produced by consumable metal electrode is protected by inert gas? In MIG welding, that is a metal inert gas welding, the arc is formed between a continuous automatically fed metallic consumable electrode and a welding job in an atmosphere of an inert gas, and hence this is called as a metal inert gas arc welding, that is a MIG welding. Next question. In which of the following gas welding process a non-consumable electrode is used? Now, in a tungsten inert gas welding process, a non-consumable electrode is used, which is made up of a tungsten and does not melt during the welding. And filler metal can be added separately. You can see in this diagram. Okay, so that's why in this case our answer is the tungsten inert gas welding, which is a non-consumable type of electrode. Next question. What is the purpose of an inert gas used in TIG welding? Now, in inert gas which is used in a TIG welding is the argon. Even you can go for the helium or the mixture of argon and helium to protect the molten metal from the atmospheric contaminations. And that's why in this case, our answer is to just protect the molten metal from the atmospheric contamination. Next question. Non-consumable electrodes are made up of. Now, the non-consumable electrodes are those electrodes which do not get consumed as the welding operations proceeds. And these electrodes are primarily made up of either carbon or graphite materials. So it can also be made by the tungsten. But here in this option, there is no tungsten. So that's why here your answer is non-consumable electrodes are made of either carbon or graphites. Next question. What is the name of the part of the TIG torch for holding the tungsten electrode? Now, tungsten electrode, even if you see in this diagram, in this video, the tungsten electrode is held in a collet. Okay, this is the collet. And over the collet, there is a collet body. And a complete assembly, I can say, is fitted inside that TIG torch. Okay, so here also I shown the collet. Okay, inside that we have inserted the tungsten electrode. So that's why our answer is a collet. Next question. welding process by metal inert gas welding is, now we know that the next question, the welding process by metallic inert gas, that is a MIG welding, is, now in MIG welding, the consumable electrode is in the form of wire reel, which is fed at a constant rate through the feed roller, and because of its continuous feed, the MIG process is faster than the TIG welding, and that's why our answer is B. Okay, so in B, the MIG welding is faster than the TIG welding. Next question, what is the consumable electrode of high melting point used in TIG welding? Now there are four options you can see. Now actually the carbon electrodes is used in the carbon arc welding to produce the arc between the electrode and the material being bonded, and copper electrode are used in the spot welding, and the aluminum electrodes are used in the metallic arc or the carbon arc or the other type of welding processes. But the tungsten electrode is the non-consumable electrode which is used in the TIG welding, and because of their hardness and their resistance to high temperature, tungstens withstand the temperature up to 3400 degrees Celsius, which make it suitable for the arc welding, and that's why our answer is C, tungsten electrode. Next question, in MIG welding process, the gas used for welding aluminum, so if you are going to weld like a non-ferrous metal, like I can say that titanium or aluminum or even a magnesium, you will need to use the pure argon gas, because pure argon gas will give the excellent result on all the aluminum welding in the MIG welding process, and that's why our answer is A, pure argon gas is used for welding the aluminum material. Next question, which of the following gas welding process uses constant voltage? Now generally in the submerged arc or even if I say the TIG welding or even the stud welding, we does not use the constant voltage source, but in the gas metal arc welding uses the constant voltage power sources. The arc voltage is established by setting the output voltage which can be seen on this machine, and that's why we can say that the gas metallic arc welding process uses the constant voltage. Next question, how the filler wire is fed in GMAW welding process? Now the, we know that the wire feed in the GMAW, that is the, I can say the metallic arc welding or gas metallic arc welding process, is done by the separate wire feeder machine. Okay, by just pressing the button of the torch wire will come out automatically while it is used as a consumable electrode during the weldings, and that's why we can say that the all this process is done automatically, and that's why your answer is C. Next question, in inert gas metal arc welding, Now, there are again four options. If I go for the argon gas or a helium gas, we know that helium gas is lighter than the air, and large flow rates are required, which will not react with the molten metal, which is used for the aluminium and other ferrous metals, especially for the thicker metal in comparison with the argon. And that's why we can say that the argon is used for welding the thin material, and helium is used for welding the thick metal. That's why our answer is A. Next question. What is the device used to show the volume of the inert gas allowed to go to the welding torch in the TIG welding? Now, there are two flow meters, okay, you can see in this diagram. And one flow meter shows the volume of the gas inside this cylinder, and the other flow meter will show the volume of the inert gas allowed to go towards the torch, welding torch. And that's why we can say that our answer is, if you want to go for the checking of the volume of the inert gas, we always go for the flow meter, which is shown in this diagram also. Next question. Gas tungsten arc welding, GTAW, or a tungsten inert gas welding, that is a TIG welding, is used for nearly all the, I can say, all the weldable metals can be possible in the TIG as well as the GTAW. Okay. Then, even if you go for the, this is what I have shown the, this diagram indicates that I'm showing the quality of the weld, which is very good in the TIG welding. Even if you go for the bicycles, right, it is possible with the help of TIG welding, you can get a very smooth weld there. Even in the aircraft also, we can go for the TIG welding. And even this is the marine boat that we have shown, which we are going for the proper welding with the help of a TIG. So that's why we can say that all of the above answers are right in this case. Okay. So next question. Which gas is used in inert gas in GTAW for increasing the speed? Now, it has been noticed that the addition of hydrogen to argon promotes the increasing welding speed due to the hydrogen significantly increases the volume of the molten metal in the weld pools. And that's why our answer in this case is that hydrogen gas is used in a inert gas as an inert gas in GTAW to increase the speed. A next question. In plasma arc welding, the gas is, so in plasma arc welding, the gas is actually ionized. The tungsten electrode is placed in the torch, and arc is infused with the gas, and this causes the gas to ionize, and it conducts the electric arc. And that's why our answer is A, ionize. Okay, next question. What is the only difference between plasma arc welding and TIG welding? Now, if I show you this, this is a torch which is used in the TIG welding, and this is also the torch which is used in the plasma arc welding. This is the only difference I can say, that the construction of the plasma arc welding torch and the construction of the TIG welding torch is different, and all other remaining parameters will be same. And that's why our answer in this case will be the B. Construction of the torch is different. Okay. Next question. How heat affected zone is covered and protected from atmospheric containment in the GTAW. Now, argon gas is used to protect the molten pole of the metal against the element in the atmospheric, including the oxygen, nitrogen, and hydrogen. Argon also plays an important role in maintaining the arc stability and gives a better weld appearance. And that's why our answer is A, argon gas. Next question, what is the name of the defect in which the weld metal did not melt with the base metal in the TIG process, which is called as actually the incomplete fusion, okay, or I can say the lack of fusion. So these type of welding defects occur when there is a lack of fusion between the base metal. So this creates a gap in the joint that is not filled with the molten metal. You can see here, such type of defect is caused due to the low heat input or the surface contaminations. And that's why our answer is C, incomplete fusion, or I can say the lack of fusion. Next question, what is the defect caused by high current in TIG welding? So too high current in the TIG welding causes the undercut, which results in the weakened weld and the workpiece. It also reduces the cross-sectional thickness of the base metal. So this welding imperfection is the groove formation at the weld. And that's why, or if you increase the current, a high current, then the undercuts are occurring. Such type of defects are occurred. Next question, what is the angle of inclination of a welding torch for a flat portion in GMAW welding process? Now, from this diagram, it is very clear that the inclination of the torch from the flat portion in GMAW is around 10 to 15 degree. And that's why our answer is B, 10 degree to 15 degree. Next question, this is the last question. What is the usual torch angle tilt on either side of the vertical in GMAW? Now, if you see in the diagram, I have shown that the inclinations on the vertical side, on either side, is 10 to 20 degree. So that's why here also our answer is A, 10 to 20 degree can be tilted on either side of the vertical in a GMAW. So thank you, friends.